Tom, since arbovirology is a relatively classical subject, I thought it was reasonable to start in a classical way with the interview and start at the beginning. So let's start by your telling us something about your early formative years and what influences there were that got you started in your interest in arbovirology.
Well, I think I have to go back to years in high school. I went to a boarding school where I had a biology teacher, Mr. Mayo Smith, who was very influential in my that time in my life. And I took biology relatively early and then did a number of projects with under his direction, one on the genetics of fruit flies and some other projects during 2 years at my last 2 years at high school. It really whetted my appetite for biology, and it was quite clear that when I entered college that that was going to be my major. I became interested in classical evolutionary biology at that point, a freshman year of college, and in particular was influenced by a course that I took freshman year in herpetology at the Museum of Comparative Zoology at Harvard. The curator of herpetology, Ernest Williams, who ran this course, it was a very small group of students, and he brought in influential scientists from outside, and it was, I was very excited. And in fact, I began at that time a series of studies at the museum, mainly anatomical and studies and some physiological studies on salamanders, on the hearing apparatus of salamanders, and developed a strong interest in evolutionary biology, interacted with all of the greats at the Museum of Comparative Zoology. The director at first was Romer, the famous comparative anatomist, and then Ernst Mayr took over, and it was a very exciting place at that time. This was in before molecular biology was on the scene, and this was a very exciting place for me. And I spent many hours and weekends in the basement, the sub-basement of the museum, where there was a hatch door in my lab, and down below was where Louis Agassiz had kept his fish classical studies many years before, taking salamanders out of jars and dissecting them. And this led into my first of four expeditions during the summers, in which I worked collecting herpetological specimens and studying reptiles and amphibians in the field.
Now, you're in undergraduate school, you're having a great time with a subject you really love, mm-hmm. and suddenly you decide you're going to go to medical school. Or maybe it wasn't suddenly, but can you tell us something about at what point you think that became clear to you that that's what you wanted to do and why?
Yeah. Well, I had the option, really. I'd worked for 3 years or more on at the Museum of Comparative Zoology, and I had to make a decision. Was I going to become a PhD herpetologist or seek another direction? And I think at that point it was clear to me that I wanted to do something more practical, perhaps more more directly influencing the course of humanity, and medicine seemed the obvious choice. It was also clear at that point that in areas of evolutionary biology there was decreasing funding available, and that which would be a hard road to follow to attempt to make a career in evolutionary classical biology. So medicine seemed the logical approach, and I applied to medical school senior year, haven't regretted it. I continued, however, to do for 2 years to work with the museum. I did two subsequent trips collecting reptiles in the tropics, and I think those were really when I got the idea that I'd like to combine medicine with an experience in the tropics, especially if I could utilize this interest and skill in natural history and zoology, and combine that with my medical career.
As I recall, at least one of those trips resulted in perhaps one of your first encounters with some of the folks at Harvard who were involved in tropical medicine, which was probably, in fact, did have some influence, I guess, on your career.
It did,
on
indeed.
Your career.
I came back after my first year of medical school from French Guiana, having spent the summer traveling in dugout canoes almost to the Brazilian border up a river and living with the Indians, and it stopped my taking chloroquine about a week after I got back, and was sitting in a classroom when I developed a shaking rigor, and went over to the school physician who diagnosed, felt my enlarged spleen and diagnosed infectious mononucleosis, although I knew exactly what I had. Wound up on the male ward of the Peter Bent Brigham Hospital with malaria. And as soon as Tom Weller's group, Tom Frothingham, Frank Neva, came over to examine me, and they looked at the smear and determined it wasn't falciparum, so they asked me whether I wouldn't mind not being treated until they could make enough smears of my blood to provide all of the medical students for the next 200 years with some teaching material. So I in those days, there wasn't that much imported malaria, so my case was presented at Grand Rounds, and the most important thing was that I really met the people in the Department of Tropical Medicine, and then had a course in tropical medicine that same year, and became known to Tom Weller and his group, and that really resulted in an elective that I did while in medical school, where I went to the Gambia under funds that Tom Weller's group supplied, and worked in Ian McGregor's MRC lab in the Gambia for about 4 months on malaria. And so that was, you're right, that experience with the disease led me to actually become involved in parasitology somewhat down the line.
Now, again, at some point in your medical school days, you had to make some decisions about which area of interest you were going to follow. Do you recall anything in particular that sort of led you toward virology as opposed to parasitology, for example?
Mm-hmm. Well, I remember being very profoundly influenced by a talk that I heard, must have been senior year at medical school, by Telford Work, who at that time had left CDC, or was about to leave CDC, and he came through and showed his movie on Kaisaner forest disease, and described the process whereby this new disease was investigated in India in the 50s. And that disease really incorporated all of the elements of a disease which required or had a complex natural history involving wild vertebrates, insects, and humans. And the process whereby Kaisaner forest disease, its epidemiology was elucidated, was fascinating to me, and it fit very closely my ideal of a kind of discipline in which I could apply this interest in natural history and the tropics with medicine. Now, that happened to be a viral disease, and I was then prepared when I came for interviews at CDC that same year for this prepared me to be impressed that arbovirology might be the best way to go when I joined CDC. Those were the years of the Vietnam War, and everybody in medical school had to make a choice of what they would do following internship or junior residency. And CDC and NIH were two strong possibilities. and I selected CDC and had an opportunity then to interview here, and arbovirology was one of the groups that I talked to. But I had a strong interest in laboratory medicine, and that continued right through medical school, and it was a natural then that when I came to CDC, I wanted to find an opportunity that would allow me to not only do the field and epidemiological sorts of things that I knew CDC was famous for, but also to maintain an interest in laboratory medicine, laboratory research. The discipline of arbovirology lends itself to that. These are multifactorial diseases, and the study of which depends upon a breadth of knowledge about the natural history, the ecology, epidemiology, but also the ability to address questions that come, that are posed by nature through laboratory experimentation. And when the arbovirus section at that time, as it was constituted at CDC, was such a complete multidisciplinary group, I stepped into a group that demanded that one take a broad approach that combined epidemiology and laboratory. And I think the present division in Four Collins is just an extension of what had been started many years before by people like Tull Work and Phil Coleman, who had put together a multidisciplinary, broad, combined epi and lab program. And strong interest I'd had in laboratory science as well as a field aspects in tropical medicine that led me to select the arbovirus group. It seemed tailor-made, and I just heard Tell Work's movie on KFD.